All right, pressure ulcers. These are fun, not as quite as much fun as neoplasms, but most people that start out in the medical field, when they're young, they end up working in, well, they used to be called nursing homes, now they're skilled facilities and stuff like that. And so most of us have time in there, and pressure ulcers is something that is kind of the bane of the healthcare profession because they're very hard to treat and prevent. So it was asked by one of the students previously, you know, pressure ulcers, how do we code them? Because they are, you have to code the site where it's located, and you have to code the stage. And so she wanted to know, is it site, stage, or is it site, stage, stage? So let's go into, first let's figure out what a pressure ulcer is. Pressure ulcers on the skin reduce the flow of blood to the area. Without enough blood, the skin can die and an ulcer will form. And an ulcer is literally like a cold, you know how you get a cold sore on your lip or something like that? You know, that's what's happening. You are more likely to get a pressure ulcer if you're in a wheelchair. Doesn't matter how old you are, but you've got constant pressure on your buttocks and your sacrum and stuff. And usually, if you're in a wheelchair, you can't feel, so you don't know when it's starting to go numb. You're an older adult, can't move certain parts of your body without because of a spinal injury or multiple sclerosis, have a disease that affects the blood flow, including diabetes or vascular disease, you know, like PVD or neuropathy and stuff like that, and you're not able to feel. You have Alzheimer's disease or another condition that affects your mental status. In other words, you're sitting for a long period of time and you don't think to get up. You know, you have fragile skin. The older you get, if you've noticed, if you looked at somebody that's, you know, a whole lot older than you, you'll notice their skin gets papery thin, and you can see the vessels and stuff. Have urinary incontinence or bowel incontinence. Again, this goes with Alzheimer's disease. If you're sitting in a chair and you don't, you know, it's not like you, Alzheimer's isn't like you forgot where your keys are. Alzheimer's is like when you can't remember what a key is used for. So you know, if you can't remember that you have to go to the bathroom when you feel that discomfort, you have urinary incontinence. Okay, do not get enough nutrition, malnutrition. That's another key way to have problems. So that if you scroll down just a little bit, here are the main places that pressure ulcers occur. The back of the neck, there, the head because of the bed. On your elbows, if you've ever had to be bedridden, like if you were pregnant or something, they made you stay in bed for a long time, and you're constantly pushing yourself, sliding yourself up in the bed, excuse me, and you'll get pressure ulcers on the elbows. Your sacrum, the tailbone, buttock area, you know, because that's where people like to lay on their backs and stuff, or on, you know, on their sides, their sacrums. That's why they have to, you know, they say you have to move every 2 hours or more often. The ankle and the heel, you don't think about that, but if you're not moving and your foot sits for 2 hours in one position, your foot can go numb. So that's the most common places. Now let's get into the coding aspect of it. So we'll scroll down just a little bit, and these are the common codes for pressure ulcers. You got 707, and they start with a zero, and it goes all the way down to different body parts. And they mainly list those red bulleted areas that we were talking about. And then there's stages. Now these are going to be 707.2 codes, and each one of those is going to indicate a different. I didn't list all of these because I wanted to give you this description so you have a better understanding. Stage one is considered superficial lesion with discoloration of the skin, but the lesion's not actually an ulcer at this point. It presents as a non-blanching reddened area on the skin. Stage one indicates a higher risk for serious pressure ulcer, but does not cause much suffering or increased treatment burden. Okay, so this is why the nurses will go in, and they're supposed to go in and check often your elderly people that are, you know, in the nursing home that are on bed rest or bedridden. And they're constantly checking the skin to make sure that this is not happening. Now, let's jump to a stage three, and it goes stage one, two, three, and four, and oh gosh, off the top of my mind, I think it's stage five. So three, the difference in that is you've got a serious pressure ulcer with full thickness skin loss, if you can imagine that, and damage or necrosis. Necrosis means dead, that extends into subcutaneous soft tissue. So now you can see why your terminology is very important. You need to know necrosis means dead and subcutaneous. What layer is the subcutaneous? And that's where it's getting into the fat. Extensive treatment and direct suffering are involved in this stage. So stage three is pretty bad, but it can be healed, and pressure ulcers have to be healed from the inside out. That takes a long time. And can you imagine a bedridden person who's diabetic already having a stage three? You know, it can be life-threatening for some people. So let's scroll down, and let's say we have a pressure ulcer of the left hip, stage one, pressure ulcer of the right heel, stage three. Now, excuse me, I'm starting to sound like Laureen coughing. That wasn't meant to be funny. Take a quick drink. Okay, so now this is kind of misleading because one of the guidelines for ICD-9 about the order to code things in, you would think, okay, well, the first listed thing is pressure ulcer of the left hip stage one. So we're going to list that first. But in actuality, you don't. You always go with the most severe. And a higher stage is a more severe ulcer. It doesn't matter where it's located on the body. They want to know about severity. So we're going to code first the ulcer that's a stage three. Pressure ulcer right heel, that's 707.7, right is the modifier. And what stage? It's stage three. And it's real easy because it ends in a three. So you know the stages are 707.2, and whatever stage it is, that's, you know, more likely the number. So we have a stage three. It gets listed first. It's more severe. Then we have another pressure ulcer, 707.04 of the left. It's a modifier left for the hip, and it's a stage one, 707.21. That's how it's coded. You would not code the 07 and the 04 and then 2-3 and the 2-1. You want to keep them separate, so you list the ulcer, then what stage? The ulcer, what stage? Depending, and people can have multiple ulcers. Now, if you want to be more educated on ulcers, one of the best things you can do is go Google it. I did not add any of those pictures because we don't know how many of you have weak stomachs, but they can be pretty horrendous. And if you're into wound care, you're involved, you know, wound care coding, it takes a lot of, you'll have a lot of these in there. Pay attention to that. Go Google pressure ulcers images if you want to see how bad these can get and how they can be, you know, life-threatening if not taken care of. But that's how you code them.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.